since I came out to play. Been face to face with all our fears, learned our lessons through the tears, made memories we knew would never fade. One day my father, he told me, son, don't let it slip away. He took me in his arms, I heard him say, when you get older, your wild heart will never be your days. Think of me if ever you're afraid. He said, one day,
shining stars. He said, go venture far beyond the shores. Don't forsake this life of yours. I'll guide you home no matter where you are. One day my father, he told me, son, don't let it slip away. When I was just a kid, I heard him say, when you get older, you wild heart will live for younger days.
He
said, one day.
Montage video of some of the trips I've been on, and then I'm going to explain afterwards what the trip was, some of my favorite parts, some of my least favorite parts, and kind of give it a little rating. Convention, youth convention called Winterfest in Gatlinburg, Tennessee. Going into it, I had no idea what I was getting myself into. I had no idea what I was doing. I had no idea what it would be like. I'd never been to Winterfest. I'd never been to CYC. I'd never really been to a youth conference with other youth. I've been to National Work Camp, which is something that we're going to talk about in 2 weeks in my next video. But this trip, by far, was my favorite. There were so many different youth groups from all over the world. So many different places. And I didn't realize that at the end of the day, there are so many Christians that surround you on a daily basis. It was kind of like a realization that the people that are here with me believe in the same thing that I do and love the same things that I do. And so, and sing the same songs as I do and read the same scriptures I read and do the same daily devotionals that I do. You know, like this was an eye-opener for me. And what Winterfest kind of is, it's a winter, obviously, convention for youth groups. And you take your whole youth group to this convention, you stay in a hotel, and then every day, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, you go to worship. And you either go to the early service or the night service. So my group went to the late service. It was honestly like, it was honestly good because we didn't feel rushed to get there super early. We had time, and so we had free time Saturday, and then Sunday we left. Obviously, when I was thinking about this, I was trying to think about like things that I love, things that I hated. And it was really hard to come up with something that I hated about this trip. I think the only thing that I really struggled with was waking up early and going to bed so late. Because I don't do those. I go to bed really early and then wake up super early. You know what I mean? So like, I never really experienced the whole staying up till 2 a.m. And then having to get up at 6 a.m. So that was a struggle, but I made it. And then something I really didn't like was, this is the one trip I think I've been on that, like, you're kind of segregated. I've never really been to a convention, I guess, but, like, I wasn't really meeting new people. I was staying with my youth group and going around with them. I wasn't really, like, the past trip that I just went on in Alabama, we were in Montgomery, Alabama at Faulkner University, and we were separated into groups, like, everybody was separated. We were not with anybody we knew. And so we got to meet new people almost every single day. And that was an experience. It was, at first I really hated it. But then you get their numbers and you get their Snapchats and you start talking to them more and you realize this person lives in Florida and they love the Lord just as much as I do. And this person lives in Alabama and they read this too. Like, they do these things too. They know these songs. They read the scripture, you know? And so, I actually met someone that lives it's like 30 minutes down from Murfreesboro, and me and him are best friends now. He's the sweetest man I've ever met. He works in a Mexican restaurant. He, like, hands down, so nice, and he lives in one of the smallest towns I've ever heard of, and it's just so cool, because, like, this person goes to a church of Christ, loves God, does this, does that, the same things that I do. We sing the same songs, we learn the same things, we have the same little Bible stories from when we were younger. And so that was really cool to me. But this Winterfest did not have that. Winterfest was like, there's so many different groups and so many different people, but there's so many people you can't really meet new people. And that was a struggle for me. I was like, whoa, this is weird. This is so many people. I don't know where I'm at. And so that was one thing that, like, if I could change, I wish it was smaller so we could meet new people or we're forced to meet new people. My favorite things, which this was really easy, was worship. I, hands down, loved worship. The last night, I ended up crying. It was Sunday morning. We were having communion, and I was in tears by the end of it. I was completely just in like, I didn't even know what I was doing. I was just crying. Because it was, like, best worship, best people, best Lord ever. And so, I was just crying. And missing school on Friday. I didn't have to go to school Friday. That was cool. Loved that. And then we had so much free time. I've really never been on a youth group trip where, like, we're out somewhere else getting to explore on our own. We split up into groups on Saturday and we explored Gatlinburg on our own. And I loved it. I think that it was the coolest thing I've ever done. I think that it was literally amazing. And I would do it over and over again if I could. Because it was like we were getting to go to these shops and do these things and have these people together, and we were having fun together, and it was like an hour, or 30 minutes to an hour, I think, every time we had free time, so it wasn't like so compacted together. Every other trip I've been on is kind of like, go, 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 go. This one was so chill, and I loved that about it. And my advice is, if you ever get the opportunity to go on this trip and be at this convention, to go. It was so fulfilling, and it made my heart so happy. But next week, we will be talking about WordCamp, which is one of my second favorite trips to go on. And I will see you.